Welcome to part two. In the last video, we went over how to set up and record a performance using a smartphone for video and a TouchMix to capture the audio. In this video, we'll discuss the mixdown phase before moving on to the audio video sync and final export. Let's check it out. Now that we have our recording done, we'll set our arm channels on the TouchMix to track mode from the record play page. Rewind to the beginning of your song using the RTZ button and press play on the TouchMix to listen back to your tracks. If using headphones, you'll need to press the main cue button to send the main mix into the headphones cue. We'll do a quick mixdown of the songs by loading channel presets for each channel or manually adjusting EQ and compression for each channel, as well as adjusting channel volume to achieve a good balance. You can also use the effects wizard to add time-based effects such as reverb and delay, or you can adjust effects manually within the channel strip of each channel on the effects tab. You can also add a compressor to the main mix channel to compress your entire mix if you want. Once you have a good sounding mix, navigate to the channel strip on the two-track record channel, press the setup tab, and make sure the pickoff point is set to post. This will ensure the EQ dynamics and effects will be recorded when you record your mixdown. Now press arm on this channel. Now we're going to create a stereo mixdown of the song. Press the record play button, set the cursor at the beginning of the song, and press record. Once the mix has been recorded, press stop and wait a couple of seconds for the TouchMix to write the file. From the channel strip on the two-track record channel, select the setup tab and press MP3 export. This will create a folder on your hard drive named exports within the session folder, and two stereo files of your mix, an MP3 and a high-quality broadcast wave file, will be written into this folder. And there you have it. We now have a single stereo file that we can combine with our video. When you're ready, move on to step three, where we walk you through syncing together the audio and video files and rendering a final export. See you there.